I guess you have to have a problem if you want to invent a contraption. First you cause a train wreck, then they put me in traction. Well, first came an action and then a reaction, but you can't switch around for the wrong satisfaction. Well, you burnt my house down and got mad at my reaction. Take the effect and make it the cause. No, well, you can't take the effect and make it the cause. I didn't rob a bank because you made up the law. Blame me for robbing Peter, but don't you blame Paul. Can't take the effect and make it the cause. Cause you lost his ball. Yeah. Well, you keep blaming me for what you did, but that ain't all. The way you clean up a wreck is enough to give one pause. Yeah. Well, you seem to forget just how this all started. I'm reacting to you because you left me brokenhearted. See, you just can't take the effect and make it the cause. Well, you can take the effect and make it the cause. I didn't rob a bank because you made up the law. Blame me for robbing Peter, but don't you blame Paul. Can take the effect and make it the cause.
When problems overwhelm us and sadness smothers us, where do we find the will and the courage to continue? Well, the answer may come in the caring voice of a friend, a chance encounter with a book, or from a personal faith. For Janet, help came from her faith, but it also came from a squirrel. Shortly after her divorce, Janet lost her father. Then she lost her job. She had mounting money problems. But Janet not only survived, she worked her way out of despondency, and now she says life is good again. How could this happen? She told me that late one autumn day, when she was at her lowest, she watched a squirrel storing up nuts for the winter. One at a time, he would take them to the nest. And she thought, if that squirrel can take care of himself with a harsh winter coming on, so can I. Once I broke my problems into small pieces, I was able to carry them just like those acorns, one at a time.
Yeah.